Hi guys, my name is Dan, I'm a veterinarian, and today we're covering whipworms in the dog, also known as trachyrus vulpus, which is basically the cool name for it. So whipworms are pretty darn common in the canine species, and what we do see with whipworm is diarrhea with blood, overall failure to thrive, weight loss, and overall just a pretty sick doggy gastrointestinal-wise. Because these whipworms live in the cecum and the large intestine, not so much the small intestine, we do see some blood in the diarrhea or in the stool, which may tip us off that we have a whipworm infection.
So now you're thinking, Dan, but how did my dog get whipworms? Like, we are the epitome of a healthy dog.
And yes, your dog may be amazing and healthy, but whipworms are actually really easy to get. The whipworm, which is really, really small, about 5 to 6 millimeters in length, is hard to see, and even worse are their eggs. The eggs are shed off and on throughout the life cycle of the whipworm. So when the dog does shed the eggs in the poop or in the feces, the eggs are microscopic and we can't see them with our eyeballs. So when these whipworms hit the ground, they can live, no joke guys, for years. Years. And once they hit the ground in a couple weeks, they're ready to start infecting other doggies. So your dog walks over that area and steps on where the poop used to be or is or whatever, but the whipworm is still there. They lick their paws, lick the ground, whatever. They get the whipworm. So once the doggie gets it, it's even harder to get rid of it because now the dog may be reinfecting themselves because they poop in the backyard, it gets in the soil, and they just keep reinfecting because they have so much exposure to the whipworm in their own environment. At this point, you're thinking, we gotta figure this out, Dan. So you roll into the veterinary office and maybe your dog does have some of the symptoms I just talked about, like the diarrhea and the bloody diarrhea. Either way, when you roll in, the veterinarian is going to do a thorough physical, as always, and they will get a poop sample. We keep going back to this because everyone's like, Dan, why do we need a poop sample like yearly or if we're sick? It's because I don't like guessing. I want to know exactly what's in the poop. That way I can treat the doggy the best way possible. So we get a poop sample, put it under a microscope, we scan, and we try to see if there's any parasites in there. So once we diagnose the whipworm egg, because it's shedding, we have to treat it then. Oh my goodness, there's so many dewormers to pick from. Your veterinarian will pick one and it should work quite well. Now, the kicker is, the challenging part is, the whipworms are still in the environment and we're reinfecting over and over and over again. So maybe we got cleaned up on the first of the month and we don't have any more parasites now. But as I said before, the eggs live for a super, super long time. So we go back outside and maybe we have some poop that's in the soil and you don't see the poop anymore because you cleaned it up beautifully. But some of the debris or residue of it's on the ground. There's a whipworm egg in there you can't see. And the doggy sniffs the ground, licks the ground, and boom. Awesome, we're reinfected. And now we have bloody stool again. Like 3 weeks later we do. So we have to have a game plan to stop that from rehappening. A couple of things you can do. Your veterinarian may prescribe a dewormer and then re-prescribe it again months later to hopefully help break any reinfections or life cycles. My preferred method, if we do have a whipworm issue in the environment, is just doing a heartworm preventive that has a whipworm medication in it. So whipworm meds like milbemycin is an easy one. That's commonly in a handful of different heartworm meds, and your veterinarian can pick one of those instead of doing the ivermectin-based ones. And then by getting the monthly heartworm preventative, we're also preventing whipworms and intestinal parasites. That's an easy way to help solve the problem. If you guys have any experience with whipworms, whipworm eggs, fecals, bloody diarrhea, anything I just covered in this incredibly entertaining video, please go ahead and comment below. Leave a little message. I'd love to read about it. And you all have a great week.